Okay, so we're looking pretty good on these hives. It was a cold evening and cold night, but this one's looking good, and this one's looking really, really good. Some orientation flights over there after I've made a marshmallow with a tarp on it. But we're gonna check out the other hives on top of the container, see how they're ending up after they're
installed. Out of all these hives, we have three on top here that are active. Here's the biggest marshmallow with two supers on it. These guys are looking great. There's a lot of activity. They're coming in and out. They're throwing out the dead bees that didn't survive the cold evening, but I think they're looking very healthy. Very nice hive. Now these other ones over here, on the other hand, I don't think are doing as well. I think we've insulated this one a little late and there's not much activity here. We're talking very little bees coming in and out. I think we have pretty much lost this hive already. And I think the same goes for the other one. This one that is insulated the best. I like this box the most. Unfortunately, I think we've added it a little too late. The activity is very low. I think they're on their way out. I think they will be dying if they survive. I will be very surprised. I think effectively we've lost two hives already. We'll see how it goes without treating any of these. Let's keep our fingers crossed and that we've at least retained some of these hives.
After wrapping these hives, I'm noticing an interesting phenomenon. The one that is wrapped up like a marshmallow here has what could be considered as a lot of activity, bees coming in and out. Whereas this control hive that I have here, which I did absolutely nothing to, and I know there are bees inside, they're still inside the hive because it's super cold today, even though it's sunny. There's one bee landing there. Not too much activity. So I'm thinking that this is actually starting to show that perhaps the hives being cold has something to do with the mite population. I guess we'll find out early next season.
Unlike the other hives, this hive is doing really, really well. They're bringing in pollen. There's a bunch of bees coming in and out. I saw a few with a bunch of pollen on their legs. These guys are doing awesome. And this is what, mid-November now? It's looking like this hive is going to survive. It's booming right now. Whereas the other ones, nothing. Absolutely nothing.
December 1st, quite a milestone for us. These guys are still alive and well. Same as these insulated ones. Doing great. And one of the ones up on the container is alive. The other ones are gone, as we suspected. So a total of three without treatment, still alive. Let's see how we do.
Well, these guys are doing great on top of the container, bringing in pollen and all sorts of activity, which is wonderful. And also the ones over there, two of them are okay. The original one and the one that's wrapped. But these two are not. I opened up the last one. All the bees are gone from that one. So they already upped and decided to forego their accommodations from this hive. I'm gonna take the super off the top, harvest some honey. I'm gonna open this one up. This one's gone as well. So we're down to three. Let's see how we do.
December 24th, Christmas Day. Or as in America, day before Christmas Day. And all the bees are doing great. Even these girls up here, up on top of the container. The other ones back there, gone. But this first one, live and well, no treatment. Zero treatment this year and three hives, live and well.
January 31st, which is beginning of February. Look at this beauty. These guys are all in a frenzy. First day of nice weather after the rains. Look at them go. They survived the winter. Same with the ones on the container. Beautiful, three hives alive.
February 22nd, 2021. I think we can officially say that these girls have survived. Same as those, and some boys, of course. This is wonderful. I got three that are left. One on the container as well. Wow, this is gonna be exciting. Pretty soon these girls are gonna start swarming.
Here it is, March 2nd. And these girls in this small hive, I already
trying to find a way to swarm. It's not going to take too long. I think within the next 2, 3, maybe up to 5 days, they'll be out of this hive. I'm purposefully not expanding this hive. This one's always going to stay this small. I want to see what happens. I'm just glad that all these girls survived, all three. They're doing great. What a beautiful day today. All the hives are doing great.